Thank you. That gate up ahead is known as the Open Arms, and Yulmore itself lies beyond. This, meanwhile, is the aptly named Gate Town, the dwelling place of the many desperate souls who hope to be chosen to live in the city proper.
Ah, I thought I recognised you. Brought a new friend, eh? I'll bet you got a trick or two up your sleeve. Maybe even three. Care to show me?
He's not here to compete. Leave him be.
What? I was only making conversation.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please! Greetings to our hopeful petitioners, one and all! Yulmore extends its warmest regards. Let it be known that a lady of distinction wishes to dine on fish divine. We seek a master culinarian who can guarantee seafood perfection. Dazzle the matron with your delicious dishes, and life in the city will be yours to enjoy, even on days when fish is not on the menu. You will answer the call. Name yourself or another. We may not at all.
Fish is in good. Was there anyone?
What about that girl?
Do you recall how I said Yulmore was a centre of power and authority? Well, that is not the only reason for its fame. It is also known as the City of Final Pleasures. The noble and the wealthy who survived the flood gathered here to live out the rest of their days in decadent abandon. A poor man could sooner pass through the eye of a needle than Yulmore's gates. The only way the common folk can enter this perverted paradise is if they fulfill the whim of one of the privileged, and so they are picked over like market produce.
Back. Having seen your all too obvious charms, we welcome you with open arms. Come, join us in the City of Splendor and live out your life in an ecstasy of endeavor.
Ah! Oh, just look at those expectant faces. What could you possibly be waiting for?
Well, well, what have we here? An extra share of Mio to celebrate our newest resident! For you!
Ah, hello!
Enjoy!
Thank goodness!
Meal is a foodstuff which Yulmore routinely doles out to the people of Gate Town, and apparently a staple for its citizens as well. Many here rely on it to survive in these times of scarcity, yet the whole arrangement just seems... well, let us just say it leaves a bad taste in my mouth.
there you are.
The thief who claimed the harvest on my behalf. Hand it over.
Well, forgive me. I have to get into the city. I have no family and all my friends have already been chosen. No one here gives a damn about me. When the meal gets handed out, I'm lucky if I get a smell of it. No matter what I do, they won't call out my name. I'm so tired, I'm so bloody hungry. I thought maybe I could steal your idea, get in that way.
What is your name?
Kai Shear.
Tell me then, Kai Shear, must it be your more or nothing? What of the Crystarium? They may not offer charity, but you would be fairly compensated for any work you did.
No, no, it has to be your more. That's where all my friends are. We made a promise that we'd live together in paradise.
I was to make my deal with the Ondo at the Clave. Listen carefully, and I shall tell you my plans for the business, and how best to arouse the Ulmoran's interest.
You'll give me your place? Just like that?
I'm giving you a chance, nothing more. What comes of it is entirely up to you.
I understand. Oh, thank you, thank you!
This was but one path. There will be others. But for young Kai Shear, it was the difference between life and death. I do not regret my decision, yet I will admit that a part of me wonders if it was for the best. We strive to bring swift salvation to this world, that countless lives might be saved, not least your own. Even if it came at the cost of one man, should I have forged on regardless? I suppose not. Were Astinian here, he would most likely scoff at my soft-heartedness.
Same old Alfino, ever the slave to sentiment.
But I thank you for your kind words nonetheless. Let us see to it that both these stories have a happy ending. Shall we return to write then? Is that... Sure, but I think someone's in trouble. Come on, they may need our help.
Redemption is beyond us. The lament of all but saints and fools, and the comfort of the lords and ladies of this accursed place. Once they held fast against the madness, only to embrace the coming cataclysm and delight in the end of days. Perhaps in rapture they seek to lose themselves and the misery they share. Or perhaps for them alone, the promise of eternal pleasure really does hold true.
then.
Lord and Lady Chai, pray forgive our intrusion. I am given to understand you were in search of an artist.
Ah, you must be the new,
Oh, goodness me! What an adorable boy! That silken hair, those pearly cheeks, and you even smell wonderful, like a bed of flowers. Approve of this one, dearest. I am positive he'll paint us the most delightful pictures.
Yes. Well, as long as he paints better than that talentless wretch we sent packing last week.
Wonderful, wonderful. Welcome to Yulmore.
Alfino, if it please you, my lady. And this is my assistant.
Your assistant? I've heard of folk bringing in family members, but this seems a bit irregular. Aren't you a little young to have a protege?
We are family in all but name, my lord. Though we share no blood, we have stood by each other through life's many challenges. Resolve to prevail together or not at all. Of all people, 'tis he who best understands my work. With his unique insight guiding my hand, the art I create is sure to satisfy your expectations. Once the picture is begun, of course, I shall have no need of constant encouragement. And so I wondered, rather than him being in your way, might it then be permissible for my assistant to explore the city he has so longed to see? Out of gratitude for his priceless contribution to my art, I thought it only fair that I make this humble request on his behalf.
Did you ever hear of such devotion? Of course your assistant must have his wish. He shall be free to roam to his heart's content. Isn't that right, darling?
Yes. Yes, of course, dearest. Quite right.